श्रीमते श्रीलक्ष्मीनारायण परब्रह्मणे नमः। श्रीमते श्री हनुमत समेत लक्ष्मण समेत सीतायाः पतये नमः। श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। श्रीमते निगमांत महादेशिकाय नमः। अस्मद्गुरुपरम्परायै नमः। अखिलात्मगुणावासम् अज्ञानतिमिरापहम् आश्रितानां सुचरणं वन्देऽनन्तार्यदेशिकम् श्रीमद्रामानुजाचार्यश्रीपादाम्भोरुहद्वयं सदुत्तमाङ्गसन्तार्यम् अनन्तार्यमहं भजे। Namaskaram to everybody. We have been trying to appreciate the meanings of the verses of this stuti, Shri Ramanuja Chatushloki, composed by Shri Anantacharya or Anantan Pillai or Anantaruvan. We went through the meanings of the first two verses, and now we will try to understand the meaning of the third verse. Gurum Prakashaye Dhiman is an injunction. A person who acquires sampradayic knowledge and thus becomes a dhiman. Dhiman means a jnani. When he acquires the desired knowledge from a teacher, he should always try to glorify his teacher, his guru, without any inhibition or hesitation. He or she should reveal, not exactly the name, because you know, normally we do not reveal the name, the direct name of our teacher. We only try to go about it in a roundabout manner, tell the name of the place or the kula or gotra and so on, so, and then finally we may share the name, actual name. Otherwise, we are not supposed to directly say the name of the teacher. Like, for example, yes, I learned from, let us say, Srinivasan. Like this, we should not say. We have to glorify the parampara of the teacher, the ancestry of the teacher, of the guru. So, likewise, a jnani or a dhiman who has acquired such knowledge should always keep praising his guru, should always remember and share good things about his guru. If someone asks, how did you know this? Then he or she should say, naturally, it is because of my guru kripa, guru kataksha. No, we should not say, I know, I think I have been studying this for quite some time. I myself found out. No, one should not say like this. So, Gurum Prakashaye Dhiman. If someone, what will happen? If someone hides, because there are some people which we, whom we find even today, that they don't want to reveal such things as to where they learnt and so on. What happens when somebody tries to hide such things, details about guru, and then just tell people that I myself struggled for so many years and found out? What happens is that sampadayishi kshiyete, the person loses his spiritual life when he or she, they fail to glorify their guru. So that is why we find in our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, beginning with, as far as we could recollect in the recent past, Madhura Kavi Azhvar, who composed Kanninan Siruthambu, in which he glorifies his guru, his acharya, Sri Nammazhvar or Shatakopa. Tulvaye Nalvayhal Tunivar Gatke, Madhura Kavi Thotriya, says Sri Swami Deshikan, who in turn glorifies Madhura Kavi Azhvar in his magnum opus, Srimad Rahasya Trisaram, in the Guru Parampara chapter. Those who resolve to follow the path shown by Madhura Kavi, they are all set to attain all that is good in life. With this background, let us appreciate this excellent piece of stuti, which reverberates with Acharya Bhakti. Bhagavad Ramanuja, when he chose to leave the mortal coil and go to Sri Vaikuntha, Shishyas wanted to perform or to show their love and respect to Acharya's images, idols. Thus came the three famous murtis of Ramanuja, Tamana Tirumeni, Tam Uganda Tirumeni, Tamar Uganda Tirumeni, respectively in Srirangam, Sri Perambadur and Melkote. Tamana Tirumeni is still, we believe, it is the Vigraha that we find in Srirangam is still of Ramanuja's, that's how the belief is. Then the one at Sri Perambadur is he really appreciated Tam Uganda Tirumeni, the idol there, and Tamar Uganda Tirumeni, and his Shishyas and Abhimanis, they according to their likings, the third Vigraha was installed or consecrated at Melkote. And then Shishyas from Kanchipuram, they said, what misfortune did Kanchi do? Why should not have Kanchi have one Vigraha of Embrumanar of Ramanuja, and thus Kanchipuram also had one more Vigraha. So now this third verse, in the third verse, Anantayavan glorifies the murti in Kanchipuram, Hasti Dhamni. Shrutishu Smritishu Pramana Tattvam Kripayalochya Vishuddhayahi Buddhya Akaroh Kila Divya Bhashya Ratnam Jaya Ramanuja Hasti Dhamni Nityam. Hasti Dhamma, Atti Giri, in Tamil we say Atti Giri. Atti means Hasti, an elephant. Giri means mountain. It is also referred with several other names. Dhamma, Dhamma means an abode. Hasti Dhamma. Hasti Dhamni means it becomes a seventh vibhakti or locative case, as we say in the grammatical terms. In or at, in Hastigiri. Nityam Jaya Ramanuja. Ramanuja Jaya Jaya. Be victorious in Kanchipuram through this murti of yours, in consecrated by your Shishyas. Shrutishu Smritishu Pramana Tattvam. Shrutishu Smritishu Pramana Tattvam. What is a Pramana? Pramana is a source of knowledge, right knowledge. Whenever we learn something, there should be a Pramana. The knowledge should not be filled with our own imagination, our doubts and fears and so on. Knowledge should be valid. So the source of knowledge should also be valid one. Normally three pramanas, three sources are considered to be valid pramanas. Pratyaksha, Anumana and Shabda. Pratyaksha is what we gain through our senses, indriyas. Anumana is what we try to infer with what we see. When we see only smoke, we infer there should be fire, there is fire. So that knowledge about fire which is not seen is said to be through Anumana. And when we don't see smoke, when we don't see fire, but someone tells us there is fire out there, don't go, then without seeing the smoke or fire, we still believe there should be fire because this person says. So that person should be of respectable nature for us. He should not, he is not a person who normally says lies. Such is the nature of Shabda Pramana. Shabda means, let us say, the verbal knowledge. The one and two, Pratyaksha Pramana and Anumana, might mislead us. In fact, they always mislead us. That's why in Tamil they say, Kannal Kanbadam Poi, Kadal Kerpadam Poi, Thira Visaripade Mai. Whatever you see is not true, whatever you hear is not true. You should investigate and know the truth. One simple example is what we see daily. It appears that sun goes around the earth. But now we know with all the scientific this thing, we can easily say that even a school going kid would say it's only the earth which is rotating. But when we look at such things, we get deceived. So Shabda Pramana is the authenticated source of knowledge. Within the Shabda Pramana, Shruti, the Vedas, they hold the highest significance. If something is not said by the Shruti, if something is contradicted in the Shruti, then we don't take it as valid knowledge. Then come the Smritis. Shrutis are Shruyate iti Shrutihi. They are revealed knowledge. Maharishis, with the grace of Emperuman, they were able to get the mantras, the Veda mantras, let us say in their meditative trance, or they are being taught by their own gurus. And Smritis are those Vakyas which are remembered by these Maharishis out of compassion. They composed some texts in which they shared the meanings of the Shruti which they themselves learnt. So Smritis are basically based on the Shruti but composed by Acharyas, Maharishis, whereas Shruti is Apaurusheya, not composed by anybody, but they are always there, revealed by Emperuman at appropriate times. So whenever we talk about such tattva aspects like Jivatma is Shesha Bhuta to Emperuman, Jivatma is a Jnana Swarupa, Jivatma is Nitya, the Atma Swarupa has no death. Emperuman along with Pirati are the Paramatma. So where do we actually source these aspects of knowledge? What is the basis with which our Acharyas have given the Upadesha about these things? The Pramana, the source is the Shruti and Smriti. कृपया आलोच्य विशुद्धया ही बुद्धिया, कृपया आलोच्य, आउट ऑफ कंपैशन भगवद् रामानुजा हैज गॉन थ्रू ऑल द प्रमाणास, नेसेसरी प्रमाणास, हैज नॉट लेफ्ट एनी प्रमाणा, हैज नॉट इग्नोर्ड एनी प्रमाणा, एंड ही हैज गॉन थ्रू इन डिटेल ऑफ ऑल द थ्रू ऑल द प्रमाणास विथ वॉट विशुद्धया ही बुद्धिया विथ सच अ प्योर बुद्धि. We may also gain some knowledge and then go through the pramanas, but we may not be able to find out the real knowledge. Why? Because we may lack the Vishuddhi Buddhi, which was acquired by our Acharyas with the grace of Embaraman. Akaroho kila divya bhashya ratnam. Hey Ramanuja, you composed the divine bhashya, Shri Bhashya, which is an excellent analysis of the Shruti, Smriti, Vakyas, carefully dealing with the Purvapaksha. Purvapaksha means who do not subscribe to our philosophy, but either with belief or, let us say, with not with belief on the in the Vedas and the scriptures, have come out with their own tenets, their own schools of thought, which do not echo the Shruti or Smriti, the spirit of Shruti or Smriti. Shri Bhashyakara Ramanuja has carefully taken up all those schools which existed in his time and countered them with arguments based on Smriti and logic, and proved that Sri Vishishtadvaita Siddhanta is the only school of thought which follows the spirit of the Vedas, Shruti and Smriti. Such a Ramanuja, out of compassion you composed the Sri Bhashya for us, without which we would not be able to defend our Sampradaya, because we don't have that Vishuddhi Buddhi, the Shishya Parampara. When we say, when Aryan says we, it should not be taken mistaken. There would be acharyas whom Embaraman keeps sending, but normally, for normal people like me, like Aryan, that's the import here. Those who listen should not mistake, because there would be a lot of people in the listeners group who possess that Vishuddhi Buddhi, but to put it very generally. So Ramanuja, you, victory to you in Hastidhamni, in Kanchipuram, for you have given the wonderful divine Sri Bhashya to us, with which we are able to gain clarity. We should study Sri Bhashya under the divine feet of an Acharya. We should not read, study by ourselves. Those who have adhikara to study Sri Bhashya should do perform Kalakshepa. So with reference to Sri Bhashya, Anantacharya or Anantayavan, Anantanpullai, he sings in praise of the glory of Bhagavad Ramanuja in the third verse. Shrimate Ramanujaya Namaha, Shrimate Anantacharyaya Namaha, Dhanyavadaha.